The world's largest polyhalite project just got bigger. Sirius Minerals says its recently completed definitive feasibility study shows probable reserves on the shale seam at its project in North Yorkshire have increased to 280 million tonnes at an average grade of 88.4% from the previously reported 250 million at an average grade of 87.8%. I'm joined now by Paul Smith, who's a mining analyst at WH Ireland, which acts as a broker to Sirius Minerals. Hello there, Paul. Now, first of all, what is polyhalite? I'm trying to get our heads around why this is important.
Well, polyhalite is a naturally occurring fertiliser, which is found in large quantities in North Yorkshire. It's, as I said, it's naturally occurring. It's a mineral containing potassium, calcium, magnesium and sulphur. And as such, it forms four of the six basic macronutrients required for plant growth. And it's all in there in one form. There's no need to blend. All Sirius will do is mine it, crush it, granulate it and ship it out to consumers.
And sell it on. So the news today, I mean, it's a relatively minor reserve upgrade, but something to smile about, right?
Certainly. It's only a modest upgrade to 280 million tonnes, but it shows how robust the project is. The new reserve came about as a result of the mining schedules published as part of the definitive feasibility study. And as such, it's a modest upgrade, and there's still 2.7 billion tonnes of resources from only about 7 or 8% of the licence area. It's a truly huge deposit.
So why are investors excited about the company's prospects now?
Well, we're in an interesting phase for the company at the moment as it moves into funding. It's got a definitive feasibility study, which shows great returns. It's done some fantastic work on the agronomics and the demand for the product. It's a new, as I said, it's a new product to the market, but it's hoping to undercut and take market share from existing fertilisers and existing fertiliser blends.
So they've done all that homework. And do you have an idea of the size of the market for what they produce?
Well, they think there's a market of at least 80 million tonnes available to them to go after. And they, in their definitive feasibility study, only one of their options was go to 20 million tonnes. As I said, we believe the demand is there for the product. It has been shown against other leading fertilisers to work very well. And this isn't just a case of the four macronutrients. It also contains a host of micronutrients as well, which are essential for certain plant function.
So how well funded are they for a company at this stage, considering what they need to do?
Well, there is a big requirement for capital. I mean, that's no secret. They require $3.6 billion to bring the project into their full production potential of 10 million tonnes to begin with. And this they intend to do in two phases. Phase one, where they'll raise about $1.5 billion, will be for constructing the high-risk parts of the project, sinking the shaft. And then they'll move into a second lower-risk phase where they're just doing fit-out, development underground and building the process plant. So this is a big ask. There is a big funding requirement required, but the management are working hard on various sources of funding. And we're fairly confident that they will be able to fund this giant project.
Now, not long ago, Sirius Minerals was one of your top picks in the sector. Is that still the case?
It certainly is, yeah. It's a very exciting project. We like the location of it. We like the size of it. We like the long life project of it. It would be very interesting for pension funds and sovereign wealth funds to get involved in a long life project, which is really operating in the fertiliser space. There's no waste from this project. It's a very green project. And obviously, the requirement for additional fertilisers to grow food, for increased crop yields, for the growing world population.
Well, that's the lure for investors, but what about the risks? Because, I mean, if we have a look, the share price soared 40% last year. It's up 20% this year, but it wasn't all plain sailing. I mean, last year, there were a lot of delays and frustration over the permits and so forth.
There were delays. You've got to remember that the project they're proposing is underneath a national park, and so it's quite right that the authorities took a while to look at this. They've determined that Sirius going about it in the right way. The surface change will be very minor, apart from during the construction period, and people won't know there's this giant operation underground. We're in a phase now where the pace of progress is in the company's hands. They have to find the funding, but after that, everything is at their own pace. They're not reliant on anybody else yet at all now.
Well, it sounds like you're pretty serious about Sirius. Paul Smith, thanks ever so much.
Thank you.